Scott Presley, a 39-year-old actor and female impersonator, has decided his face needs an overhaul. Scott decides to trust his and Bel Air's face to Dr. Brent Mulliken, a well-known Beverly Hills plastic surgeon.
Hi, hello. Dr. Mulliken.
How are
I'm
you?
Scott. Yeah. Nice to meet you.
I think Scott's very progressive because he's doing things at a sort of a younger age. Most of my male patients come in maybe when they're in their mid-40s. I would say to late 40s would be more average. But Scott's ahead of the curve, so he saw some signs of aging and he didn't like them.
This thing bothers me a lot.
There's four muscle groups that come together to make this frown. And we'll cut those muscles so they won't be able to make the frown nearly as well.
Wow.
There's a little bit of heaviness of the upper eyelid skin, mm-hmm. so I think we ought to take some of that away. And there's a little bit of extra skin, but there's also some fat as well. And there's a little bit of puffiness here underneath the lower lids, and there's also a tendency of the corner of the eye to pull down just a bit.
Right.
So we want to make sure when we reduce these bulges here that we actually support the corner of the eye and actually lift up on the cheek like this, and then take the extra skin away. Now for this smile line here, something that I've invented is called Live Fill, and that's basically we go to the stomach, make a little cut in the bottom of the tummy right by the hairline. It will take out some of your own tissue there. And then we'll actually put it here in the smile line. So we're not doing fat injection, where most of the cells aren't alive when we're transplanting them.
Fat injection is not an accurate enough technique because the fat typically does not survive the journey, and then the body absorbs it away. So with Live Fill, the grafts are actually placed in, and they're all alive when they're placed in. So we have reason to believe in all our patients that the grafts have survived.
Like many of us, Scott is starting to see the signs of aging in his face, and he doesn't like it. As we age, the effect of gravity on the soft tissues of the face causes the skin to sag. It's estimated that between the ages of 25 and 65, more than 30% of a person's facial area drops. The most efficient way to address this problem is to remove skin.
I'm ready for my close-up, Dr. Mulliken.
The day of surgery moves very quickly for Scott. There is a brief meeting with Dr. Mulliken.
I'm not going to draw on you now, but I'm going to draw on you in surgery. So you'll wake up and there'll be marking pen on your face.
Okay.
So don't be alarmed.
Okay.
But I do want
today,
you to
Dr.
Around.
Mulliken will perform five procedures on Scott's face. Remove skin from his upper eyelids, a cheek lift, move live tissue from Scott's lower abdomen to his cheeks, liposuction his neck, and remove frown lines. A few minutes later, Scott is in the operating room with the anesthesiologist.
I just want you to just relax.
Dr. Mulliken begins the procedure by marking the places where he will make the incisions on Scott's face. He injects a local anesthetic to reduce bleeding and discomfort. Dr. Mulliken scrubs while the anesthetic takes effect. First, the doctor removes a piece of skin and fat tissue from Scott's lower abdomen. The surgeon makes an incision in the lower eyelids.
So now we're going to deal with the fat.
He removes a small amount of fat. Then he takes excess skin from the upper lid. Dr. Mulliken pulls back an underlying layer of tissue towards the outer corner of the eye.
We don't like the shape of his eye because it's going down too far. It's very sad. So we want to hike it up a little bit and give it support.
The skin is trimmed and sutured into place.
Here we still see the bulge, and we still see the hollow below the bulge. Here both the hollow is gone and the bulge is gone. And then the upper lid, it's a little cleaner, a little crisper. And here's some heaviness here in this eyelid. So I think we've got a nice before and after.
An anesthetic deadens the sensation to the cheeks. While it takes effect, the surgeon prepares the tissue harvested from Scott's stomach to be implanted into his cheeks. Now he inserts the strands through a small incision in the cheek.
So that's our incision, our only incision. It would be very hard to detect
With the live fill completed, Dr. Mulliken uses liposuction to remove a small amount of fat from Scott's chin area. The final procedure removes the frown lines between Scott's eyes.
I'm going to make a little cut right in the brow itself. There are basically four muscle groups that coalesce here, and we're going to get them all. And then we'll just hold this on for a good 3 minutes. So we've gotten these muscles taken care of here in this area. We've got his little natural cheek implants with the live fill. Got these nasolabial folds filled in. Got a better contour.